If you happen to miss out on a career with the Reds, Dream Camp is the one place you can go to make it happen. For 1 week, number 14 isn't Pete Rose. It's Cincinnati tennis pro Steve Contardi. And number five, no, that's not Johnny Bench. That's Springer. Jerry Springer.
That's right. Jerry came to Dream Camp. And you want to know something? He did okay.
Where you been?
Hey, well, it was better than we were expecting. All it took was a little hard work and some sound advice.
The hard work came before Dream Camp, when Jerry huffed and puffed alongside Dave Parker. And the advice? That came from Jerry's daughter, Katie, right before he hopped his plane to Tampa. Still, with all that help, Jerry was nervous the first day of practice.
Hope this pitcher has a sense of humor.
Then a funny thing happened. When the Dream Campers began playing games against each other, Springer became an animal. In his first real at bat, in a real Reds uniform, Jerry got a hit.
Up in the stands, it looks so easy the way they do it, and when you get out there, you realize that the ball is coming reasonably fast, but it's great. When I got a hit, I felt great.
He even looked like a major leaguer out in right field. Well, sort of. And then Jerry got carried away. He wanted to catch. It was the first time in his life. And in his first inning, wouldn't you know it, there's a close play at the plate.
Any more Titians? Might head of death here.
Well, he's surprising. He's really good, and he's very determined. I mean, he's right into every pitch of every game, and you can just see the concentration written out all over his face.
It was great. This whole week was exactly what it's called, a dream.
Oh, and Katie, your dad did just fine throwing the ball, too. Tomorrow, a look at the many different characters that make up a dream camp.
Hey, what do you say, Chihuahuas?
From the Reds' dream camp in Tampa, I'm George Vogel for News 5.